This series is funded by fans like you.
And then again, on the subway ride home with me, she made it very clear to me how she felt. And I don't blame Rose for being disappointed. She was so excited I was finally seeing someone.
Well, why do you say you don't blame her for being disappointed?
Well, I guess I expected her to be disappointed.
Could this be what was causing your anxiety?
Of course. It seems obvious now. And I'm still anxious. There's so many people I have to tell. I have to tell Johnny. I have to tell my parents. They're gonna be so let down. I can just see their faces. They're gonna...
Nathan, that's a lot of other people's feelings to worry about.
Well, they were all excited for me. I was excited for me.
Okay, I know you like me to cut to the chase. So, were you excited to be dating Valerie, or were you just glad to get people off your back about being single?
Oh, yeah, that one. Just chalk that up to another case of Nathan worrying more about other people's feelings than his own.
When you were alone with her, did you ever consider your own feelings, or were you only concerned about satisfying Valerie?
Well,
what about during sex?
Oh, actually, I didn't quite get there yet.
Am I making you uncomfortable?
No, not uncomfortable. Nope, I am very comfortable. I can definitely talk about anything with you. Very comfortable, indeed. She was an intellectual. Really, really smart. So we talked a lot. And she'd open my mind up to things. She'd challenge me. Oh my God, I'm gonna miss that.
The way she challenged you?
Yeah, but in a broader sense. Like, we would have these rich conversations that would occupy my mind. And I welcomed that, because, you know, Rose has been occupied herself lately, so.
Her starting university has really done a number on you, hasn't it?
Yeah, yeah. Oh, but she's doing so well, though.
Becoming more self-sufficient?
Yeah.
How's it make you feel?
Proud. Great. I mean, she was such a shy girl, and now she's... Well, she doesn't need me anymore.
So, remind me, you dated Valerie a long time ago, didn't you?
Yeah, Rose was really young, grade one-ish.
So when she started full-time school?
Yeah.
And we had our first session 3.5 years ago. You had just ended a relationship with another woman, hadn't you?
Angela. Oh, I was such a horrible boyfriend.
So you said. But before we get into why those relationships ended, I'd like to discuss why they started. So, what milestones was Rose going through when you started dating Angela?
None then, that I can think of. She was already in high school, so she... Oh my God. Of course, that's when she came out.
And so she's becoming more comfortable with herself?
Yeah. Oh, it's like my real daughter was finally emerging.
That's a wonderful thing to see.
It is.
So, you started dating Valerie when Rose began full-time school. And then years later, you dated Angela shortly after Rose came out, mm-hmm. growing more into herself. Right? And then you started dating Valerie for a second time when Rose started university, growing even more independent.
Yeah.
Starting to see any connections here?
Oh, this is much bigger than emptiness syndrome, isn't it?
Well, it's not unlike emptiness syndrome. I think you're a provider, and like we discussed, Nathan, you like to provide in all your relationships. And Rose is your most significant and most important relationship.
So, I only start dating when Rose doesn't need me to provide. And then it only lasts until Rose needs me again. Valerie and Angela didn't leave me. I left them, didn't I? Oh, I'm exhausted.
That's understandable. We made some big discoveries today.